We ask you to join us in a moment of silence as we remember the victims and the heroes of September 11, 2001. Now please stand and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful rendition of the national anthem in honor of remembering 9/11. We're here on a happy Sunday afternoon. I'm here with my good friend, Mr. Lindmark, back for another season together.
That's right,
and
Greg.
Welcome aboard, buddy. We have the Reading Rocket B team facing off against an always tough opponent in the Wilmington Wildcats. We look forward to the kickoff. We'll be back in a moment. Okay, here we go. Reading Rockets getting pumped up on the sidelines. We've got a coin flip, and the Rockets will be kicking off to the Wildcats to start the game, and the defense will come out first. Looks like number 14, Ben Regazzini, with the ball. He did the kicking duties last year, and looks like he's going to be doing some kicking for us right now. And
start it off, make the old man proud, is what I say.
Let's see. Okay, here we go, Rockets. Ready on the left, ready on the right.
Yeah.
And the referee's whistle, we're awaiting. Trying to get the pylons down. Here's the boot. Oh, and it's a nice one down to about the 25-yard line, fielded by number 12 for the Wildcats. He's got some room. Oh, nice stick right there. Brought down number 23, Stephen Donnelly. He was outstanding last year on special teams.
Let's see him back.
Speedy. Nice play. Okay, Wildcats coming to the line of scrimmage. Nice kick, nice tackle again by Steve Donnelly. They're on the 36-yard line. And a double wing formation. And here comes a little misdirection. Tackled, pickup of 4. And number 73 led the charge there, Colin Webb with the tackle, along with Dylan Fidali.
Look at this now, they're going into almost a hurry up.
Yep, they did this last year too.
Yep. This is the
they
same
love
team
to count,
they
run the counter and right up the belly again. Yep. Good push again up front. Another pickup of 3 or 4. It's going to bring up a third down and a long 2.
They're going to try to just smash it down their throat as best they can. That's Wilmington style. Effective when it works.
Good gang tackle up front. The entire defensive line doing a nice job there.
We got 3rd and 2.
Okay, Wildcats back to the line of scrimmage. It's a third and two at the Rocket 44, same formation. And it's a reverse, but number nine was right there. He had sealed the corner nicely. And number 23, Stephen Donnelly, cleaning it up. Good job by number nine, Dana Isbell, to stay home and force him inside again.
Yeah, it looked like number 23, Donnelly, number 33, Williamson, and Isbell all contributing on the play on that. Excellent job.
Good job by the D.
Got a fourth and one, Greg.
Yep. We'll see.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
Calling
right
a quarterback sneak, what do you think?
Well, I don't know. You know, I think they're going to go with
that
trap.
They got the big guy.
I think
they're
going to try
to
trap him.
He was off. Yeah. Oh,
yeah,
there's the
right.
Quarterback sneak, and they pick it up.
You
and
were right.
Then some. My, my.
First down.
Okay, Wildcats back to the line of scrimmage after a quarterback sneak for a first down. They're at midfield. Same formation again. They run a lot of misdirection. This is just a straight power sweep off of the tackle. Another pickup of four on the play. Awful quiet down there.
Yep.
Coach Robinson is back this year, along with Brian Keefe and Dylan Fidali, who's actually down in Baltimore doing the Ravens game today. Wish him well.
And Chris Flanagan.
Chris Flanagan
well.
Is also the out there. Happy to have him aboard. Appreciate all their leadership and volunteer work that they do here for us. Second down. Little pitch. Same play, other side. He's got some room. He's got the corner. He's at the 30. And taken down after a pickup of about 15 yards. See who got that tackle there, Brian.
Looked like maybe 73. Yeah, I'd say Colin Webb was in there. Yeah. Dylan Fidali.
Yep, Fidali was in there too. Ryan Lindmark, number 22, outside.
All ready?
Okay, back at the line of scrimmage, first down at the 29-yard line. Wilmington moving the football here early. Pickup of about nine. Jeez.
Yeah, they're finding holes inside that line. Unfortunately, the Reading defense right now is not able to contain them. Every single play seems to be, you know, a good 3 or 4 yards. Which unfortunately is going in favor of
big Jack Keefe, number 50, 51. Or I'm sorry, that's Ryan Sagala. That was Jack's number last year.
Yeah.
So Ryan's in to mix it up a little bit. Okay, Wilmington sticking with the successful formation. And there's a quarterback sneak. He's a big kid. Number 12, strong run. And another first down for the Wildcats.
Yeah, it looked like number 33, Williamson, was in on the tack, the tackle, almost a solo tackle. But yes, they do come across with a move the chains, first down.
Let's see. Back to the line of scrimmage. Little pitch, and it is. Oh, almost got him from behind. Number 42, Derek Van Horn, turned it back inside, which is his primary job, and he almost had him in the backfield, but they picked up a, I don't know, I think that was no gain there. So bringing up a second down in about six.
Yep.
Back to the line of scrimmage, Rockets. Working hard here as Wilmington has a sustained drive, 5:47 left in the first quarter. And there's a skank tackle. Get him down.
Yeah, he's still trying
to move. Oh, man, he's close to the stick now. Hard to tell from
here. I think
here.
It's a fumble,
Greg.
Oh,
fumble on the
Looks
play.
Looks like the Rockets got it back.
Big break. Who got that? I think
tough
it was number 50, Jack Keefe, perhaps.
Perhaps. I mean, it was an all-out.
Tough to tell.
All-out 11-man
outstanding.
Effort.
Big break for the Rockets.
Yeah, that's a huge
here
break
comes
for the
big O.
Nice
outstanding.
Job.
They went almost 70 yards on that drive before Redding catches a nice break. Okay, here we go. The Reading Rocket B team to the line of scrimmage for the first time. And we've got quarterback Nick Perez, number 12, taking his user spot at quarterback. He hands off. Nice gain right there. I think that's number seven, Kyle Flanagan. Beautiful pickup.
Nice blocking.
Outstanding
up front.
Blocking on the right side.
Yep.
Super, super pickup. Good look for the Rockets. Break the line of scrimmage. Nick Perez hustled in with the play. Fidali's in at fullback. We've got two men out wide
interesting
right.
Interesting formation.
And a little misdirection, and there he goes again. Hand off to, nice. Dana Isbell with the carry. Nice pickup of five there as they ran a little counter. Off the left side, great blocking up front, and the Rockets are moving the football here. I like what I see.
Yep.
Line of scrimmage. Donnelly behind Perez. The handoff is to Donnelly, nothing doing. Well defended up front. I'm going to take a second and just call out the coach, Coach Robinson's son, Dan Robinson. He had a real tough break. His left leg was a little scary, but we're happy to hear that the bone is on the mend. We send our love out to Dan.
Tough break. Good kid. He'll come back.
Yeah, big loss for the team, too. Two-way player, hard nose, one of the leaders of the team. Pass off target.
Nope. Incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, it's a fourth down at the 31-yard
line. Looks like we got a punt.
Yep.
And
that's it. Number 21.
Kick.
Andrew Benassi with the punt. And number 12, the quarterback for Wilmington, had some room. Finally brought down by, let's see, number 21, Andrew Benassi. So, Rockets, the tough first set. They had some momentum there, but turnover on downs is going to bring up a first down for Wilmington at about the Rocket 20. Okay, here we go. Double wing formation, and they just run this very, very well. Little dive off the right side. Pickup of about four. And we'll see if they go hurry up again here. Nope, they're heading back into the huddle on the road, killing the clock. Okay, here we go. Second down and about 6 yards for the Wildcats. Rockets got to hold tight here. The fumble last series really helped them out. Oh, nice. Nice call by the Wildcats. Oh boy, he's got the corner, but here comes a host of Rockets, pushed out by number 23, Stephen Donnelly. Six or seven guys in pursuit. He picked up about four on the play. It's gonna bring up a third down and one. Wilmington up the belly again, and they are gonna be very close to a first down, and they do have the first down just about at the 9-yard line. So it's gonna be first and goal for the Wildcats. Very methodical. All right, Wildcats. Quarterback sneak right up the belly. Down to the 5-yard line, gonna bring up a second down. And the interior line, 81 is Aiden Vinciguerra in there on the stop, along with Colin Webb. And number 33, Colin Williamson. He and Dylan Fidali, number 44, are the inside linebackers this year. Back to the line of scrimmage come the Wildcats.
Yep.
Oh, little movement there, same play. Nicely
there
done, gang tackle.
Beautiful.
Host of Rockets led by Fidali and Vinciguerra again.
23, Stephen Donnelly.
Stephen Donnelly
checking
in there.
Yep.
Nick Perez comes out, and it's going to be a third down and goal for the Wildcats.
Looks like we're at about, what, the 4-yard line?
Yeah, I think so. Big number 12 for the Wildcats. In with the play. Quick quarterback. This time they get the double wing. Right up the belly again. Off tackle, and it looks close. I think he's in, and he is.
They go
touchdown,
with that.
Touchdown,
Wildcats. That kid's got some size. You know, they give that big fullback there.
He's a big kid.
They give it to him, and he just takes like a bulldozer and goes right through people, you know.
But okay, so that's a 6-0 lead for the Wildcats. Can't tell if we're into the second quarter now when it's 8:34 left and Wilmington is dominating the clock in the early going.
It looks like they're probably going to, I see it. It looks like they're probably going to go for two,
Yeah, they did this last year.
Nope.
You're right. They're going to kick the ball.
They are going to kick the ball. Yeah.
It's 2 points, right?
No, I actually, oh, doesn't matter now.
Oh, nice play on the broken snap.
I think at this level it's one, actually. I think at this level it's one.
Okay. Huge break for the Rockets as they keep it at 6-0. Faulty snap, and Stephen Donnelly in with the heads-up play to, hey, got a visitor up here.
Yeah. All right. So about 8 minutes left in the second. We've got Wilmington 6, Reading nothing.
Okay, back live. Reading Rockets set to receive. Wildcats, look at this. They got the ball lying down at the 40. This will be interesting. Little squibber pounced on by, that might be, is it Stephen Donnelly? Yes, number 23, Stephen Donnelly.
Yep.
Heads up. All right, Rockets are going to take over here at the 46-yard line, see if they can get something going here on offense. 8:26 left here in the second quarter. How did the E-team do this morning, sir?
We tied.
All right.
Excellent. We tied them up. Wilmington was a good team. 6-6 was the end of the score.
Mr. Lindmark has three boys in the program this year.
Yeah.
Coaching the E's and running this camera. And we thank him for his contribution.
Thank you.
Okay. Rockets break the huddle here. And I'm trying to see who the center is. I don't got a good angle. Get it after the play.
Yeah.
Perez, they got a double wing set, and number 42 takes the ball. Derek Van Horn trying to get somewhere. And well defended. Loss of 2 on the play. Very, very well pursued. Back to the line of scrimmage. And Nick Perez moving Derek Van Horn. He's wing right. They've got two guys out on the left side. Number 7, Kyle Flanagan in motion, and he takes the ball.
Room.
Nice cut.
He's got some room.
Boy, good job right there as he picked up about 7. Gets him back to midfield. Excellent run. Great blocking up front on the right-hand side. And let's see what the Rockets got coming up next. Van Horn is out. Number 9, Dana Isbell comes in with the play. Or I'm sorry, there's Nick coming in. So he's in the 50s.
I couldn't tell.
All right, I formation, wing left, shotgun. The handoff again. Here's Donnelly. He's got some wheels.
Nah. Nothing.
Nothing cooking out there. Got to seal that corner with those blocks.
Looks like we're going to be about a 4th and 6.
Yep.
Which I'm not sure.
Coach
what is
Robinson.
Coach going to do here?
See.
Looks like he's keeping the offense on the field. Yep. I think he's going to go for it. Not a bad decision midfield.
Yeah. Did Nick ever do the quick kick last year?
I cannot remember.
Yeah.
I cannot remember. Well, did he kick last punt? I think it was number 8.
They got a nice tight formation. Looks like he may be powering off the right side, but no. Oh. Did not fool the Wildcats.
Not
they stacked the right side. And he did a little stutter step to the left, and they stayed home and did their job. It's going to be first down, Wildcats. Okay, here come the Wildcats. First down on the 50. Little counter play. Number 12 with the ball. Being pursued, number 9. Dana Isbell finally brings him down after a pickup of 11. Boy, they run those counter plays very well.
Very effective. Very effective. It's just a misdirection. It's so hard to pick it up sometimes, you know, because they, you know, it's almost like playing disguise with the ball. Guess where it is.
I know it. Okay, here we go. It's a first down at the 38-yard line of the Rockets. They're trying to hold off this strong Wilmington offense as they go right up the belly.
Yep.
And the entire Rocket team stops them after a pickup of about 7.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the downside of it.
Yeah.
After about 7.
Yeah. Formation. If it ain't broke, don't change it. Oh!
His ball's on the ground. No. Nope.
Nice tackle right there. Little difficulty on the handoff, and big number 7, Kyle Flanagan, came in and cleaned him up. No yards on the play. Going to bring up a third down and about 5 to go here. Number 40 rushing in. That is Kunj Patel. Out comes number 22, Tyler Lindmark. Playing some good D out there today, Dad. Here's the snap. Pitch left. Oh, nice play right there by number 9 to shed the block. And Donnelly did the rest.
Yep.
Good work between those two boys right there against a very speedy number 12 for the Wildcats.
Now they're pushing them the right way.
That's right. You got it, man.
Which is good to see because we're bringing up a big fourth down. Looks like fourth and 10. That's the thing. I think you get this Wildcat defense into a offense into a situation where they're, you know, fourth and 10, fourth and 12.
Yeah.
You know, they're not going to pass.
No, they're definitely a power football team. Absolutely.
So, you know, now you've created a situation where, you know they're going to run. Hopefully they can just stop it.
Okay, fourth down here. We've got 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first half of the Rockets opening day of the 2016 season. Wildcats back to the line of scrimmage. Let's see what the Rockets can do here. Quarterback is under center. And he's going to throw the ball.
Well,
and he's got a man wide open. And he makes the reception.
Wow. Well, that goes against everything we just said.
Wow.
Boy.
A pickup of about 25 on a nice pass.
Boy, oh boy.
He got behind the defense, and that is huge.
Yep.
With 4:23 left, the Wildcats are on the march again here.
Reading just was not prepared for that. You know, they were thinking the same as you and I, Greg. It's just going to be a run.
Absolutely. I thought they would. They might think about punting, but.
There they go and throw it and pick up a first down.
Okay, first and 10 at the 15-yard line of the Rockets after a huge first down. Little pitch and oh my, what a
interesting play.
Wow. Fake the
it's
pitch.
Like fake a pitch and give it to him.
Yep. Counter play. Well read by the Rockets. Donnelly in there again, having a good first half here so far. Number 42. Derek back to the line of scrimmage here. Second down and 9. Rockets trying to hold tough here. Oh, little reverse. Well defended again.
Nice job.
Great job. Really good job right there. Who is that? Number 20, Miguel Martin with a heck of a play. And brings up a third down and a loss of 1. And the Rockets defense seems to be working very hard here against a lot of misdirection. Not easy.
Third down, 10 yards to go, Greg?
Yep.
Are you seeing it the way I do? Yep.
I got it. Third down, 10. I can almost see that far, another year older. All right, Wildcats, break the huddle. Let's go, Rockets. We need a big defensive stand here. Man in motion, and it's power sweep with the quarterback. Great job, number 42 and number 21.
It's like Van Horn and Benassi out there.
Good pursuit. Bring down. Beautiful. Big number 12 brings up a fourth down.
Yep.
And what do you got, about 7-8 yards
here? Yeah, I'd say.
Hustling in is Ryan Mulvey, number 54. And hustling off is Cole Mogino. Colin Williamson in the middle back there, number 33. Up front, you got Owen Schroem. Number 54 is Ryan Mulvey. Number 50, Jack Keefe's down there, knuckles down. And
it's going to be a
quick throw in the flat.
And I think that's...
If he can hold on, that's a great
play. Beautiful job, Redding.
Sweet play by Colin Williamson.
Yeah, Williamson was out there.
Number 23, Donnelly, and 44, Fidali. Huge. That's Rockets take over on downs.
Beautiful.
All right. Okay, the Rockets break the huddle with a first down at the 10, just shy of the 10-yard line. It's an I formation with a wing right, Fidali fullback, and Stephen Donnelly, but the quarterback, number 7 on that play, Kyle Flanagan, they snuffed it out, and that's a loss of about 5. Bring up a second down here with about a minute and a half to go in the first half. And again in the quarterback position, double wing, Fidali, up. He dropped the ball, but he picks it up. And a little broken play there. Number 22, Tyler Lindmark, tried to help him out with a block. And tough play. Sometimes those snaps, we forget how young these guys are, you know, doing a shotgun like that every single play, just how efficient they actually are. So it's bound to happen once in a while. Going to have a third down here.
We got third and long.
Woo. 16, 17 yards.
Yeah, I mean.
The clock
I say you just throw it in the air and then, you know.
Yeah, let's
see. Because you only got 20 seconds.
Yeah.
Unless they take a knee here.
If I know Chuck, they might take a knee.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Nope. Oh, no, he's running with the football. And that's going to be the last play of the half right there. Although.
If that clock is right.
We don't know if the play. That's the half.
That's the half.
Yep.
All right.
Sometimes the game clock we're looking at is a little different than what the refs have on the field. All right, after the end of the first half, it's 6-0 visitors here in Reading, Mass on September 11th, 1916. And then when the play is over. Okay, welcome back to the second half. Reading Rocket B squad down 6-0. Here at the start of the second quarter, Rockets set to receive. Wilmington kicks the ball. It's a nice one down to about the 35. Handled by number 42. He's got some running room. Breaks a couple of tackles. Nicely done. Derek Van Horn out to about the 48-yard line. Here come the Rockets. Okay, so Rockets in the huddle with a first down after a nice run. Great blocking by the front of the receiving team for the Rockets. And here we go, first down from the 46. Number 10, Mogino, or Michael Lloyd, I'm sorry, moving over, split right. Out of the eye, the handoff is to Flanagan. And he's gonna be taken down for a loss. A little late scrum there. Wilmington talking a little trash at the end of that play. Don't like to see that. Loss. Okay, Rockets break the huddle here. I formation. Wing right, second down and 13. It's going to be a handoff.
Got some
and rope. Need some blocking up front out there.
That's what I was looking at. I mean, he's got good speed there getting up, but... You know, without the blocking.
Taken down.
You're not going to go anywhere.
Okay, here we go. Perez in with the play. Rockets break the huddle. It's third down. 14, Regazzini is split right. And who's that behind him? Those nice Willie White Shoes Johnson's. Cleats behind him. A little mix up here.
Nah, now we got a false start. We got a.
Didn't know where. Unfortunately, the fellow on the out wide left there Wasn't quite sure.
Might have been.
So, timeout.
Was it a timeout? Yeah.
I think they had to. I think they had to use a timeout
yeah,
there.
I think they burned a timeout. No penalty. Good.
Not the end of the world, but it is a tight game. So hopefully it doesn't come back to bite them at the end. Okay, let's try this again. Back live, third down and 12 from midfield. The Rockets with the snap. And it's going to be a pass. He has a man open. Yeah. Too much pressure.
Yeah.
And still fighting is Perez. He had Michael Lloyd, if they were looking for the home run, he had some space in the back of the Wilmington defense, but a good push up front by the Wildcats defensive front, and it's going to be a fourth down and about 20.
Yeah, you know, what's the call here?
Boy, I don't know.
I gotta,
why Coach Robinson's down there and I'm up here, baby. I might punt, but, you know, I don't, the punting at this level is a challenge. Kicking, you know, the kicking game is, they're still developing as players, so it can be a crapshoot.
I don't know.
Looks like they want to throw. Nope, they're going to hand it off to big number 7, Flanagan, and just well defended up front.
Yep. Be a turnover on downs.
Okay, it's going to be first down Wilmington at the 45. When we scrimmage, first down and 10 for the Wildcats. 6:38 to go here in the third quarter. And there's that little counter. And it's effective again. And they pick up about 4 or 5 yards on that play. Wildcats back to the line of scrimmage after about a pickup of 4. And the Rockets defense is playing commendable football right now, I got to say. They're really... holding their own against this team, but here's a nice call by Wildcats. Pick up about 6 yards. Going to bring up a third and about 2 or 3. Didn't see who made that tackle. Big Jack Keefe coming off the field. Good work up front as always. See, we got Colin Webb, 73 up front right now. Tough angle for me. I think it's Ryan Mulvey, 54. Anthony Ahigian, or that's Ryan McGibbon, I think, on the outside over there. DBs, Andrew Benassi, 23, Steve Donnelly. Looking at, showed like a quick pass.
Yeah.
Ooh, big, that Up boy, he's down. A big kid. Rumbles down for close to a first down, and it's going to be good hard run. Well defended by the Rockets. He's just a big, strong kid. And it's going to be a first down at the 35-34 of the Rockets. 5 minutes to go. So the Wildcats, quarterback Sneap. Wow. My goodness.
Yeah, the whole line moved on that one.
Yeah, they got some good push.
Yeah.
Tackled by 72.
Yep, Hegan.
And 7. And 73, so 72 is, yes, Anthony Agahigian. And number 7, Kyle Flanagan. And Colin Webb is 73. But, boy, they're getting a solid push up front there. They really do tight splits back to the line of scrimmage.
Yep.
And as they did last year, they really are showing us they know how to run the football.
Oh, yeah. There's that moose again, number
55. Yeah, he's a big dude. And they're tired. He doesn't want to go down.
No.
Finally. Down on the referee's whistle. Blown dead.
That is a man amongst boys out there.
Look at him. Mommy's feeding him steak and mashed potatoes on a daily basis. How the heck did he get by the
the weight limit?
How did he get by the scale? I don't know. Crazy.
That's a Houdini-like
attempt. Unreal. Okay. Here we go. Back to the line of scrimmage, third, and about 2 yards to go here at the Rocket 36. Nothing fancy.
Just right ahead. That's it.
You know, these guys up front, it gets tiring if you've ever played in the interior defensive line.
They just keep pounding them.
You know, you're getting double teamed all day. It's hard work up front. Not a lot of glamour, not a lot of headlines, but those guys in the middle do a great job.
It's the core. It's the core.
Okay, they picked up a first down. Unfortunately, going to be a first down at about the 24 with 2:43 to go here in the third quarter. Back to the line of scrimmage. What do you think here? A little more of this?
Yeah, it's, you know, I think we're just going to see a lot of this misdirection, a lot of this, you know, everything back and forth.
Oh, ball down.
Recovered.
Almost.
Yeah,
Wildcats
recovered.
Pounce on the ball, but Rockets could use a break right here. It's a 6-0 game. Coming upon the fourth quarter quite quickly here, so the offense has been stymied so far. We need some, okay, here we go. Second down and 14 for the Wildcats. A little dive off the left tackle, well defended. Pick up a couple. And it's tough to tell from this angle, I apologize, but I think it was 54 was in there on that tackle, Mulvey. Donnelly came in from the outside. And who's that, number 80? The ref's in the way, I can't get it. Number 81, Adam Vinciguerra, helped stuff that play. Okay, here we go now. Rockets defense working hard out here, trying to keep this game close for the offense. They're gonna throw the ball.
Oh,
nothing
nice.
Doing.
Complete.
With little hands there. With 21, Andrew Benassi with the coverage. Well done. Throw is off the mark a little bit. And we'll take it, fourth down.
Fourth and long. You know, you got to think that the Wildcats are going to try to go back to the air. That would be my guess.
Yeah, fourth down here. Where are they? 25, 26 yard line.
They proved they can throw, so...
Yeah, absolutely.
We'll find out right now.
Yep.
Either way, if you're the Rockets, you got to be prepared for everything right now.
I know it. There's Big Dan Robinson. They're missing him up front.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are.
Okay, here we go. Fourth down. This is a big, big play right here for the Rockets. And he is. You're right.
Back.
He's going to throw it. He's got a man. Oh, nicely tipped by... At the last minute, great play. There you go, Dad. Number 22, Tyler Lindmark with a huge play. Total stretch. Just got a couple of fingers on it. Outstanding. Outstanding play.
Well, let's see the Rockets come back and get some offense going. Let's do that.
Okay. Okay, here we go. Rockets take over on downs after an outstanding effort by the defense right there. Ball is marked at the 25-yard line. See what Coach Robinson and his staff have planned here with 10 minutes left, according to the field clock. The Rockets are once again on offense trying to get something going. Break the huddle. In an I formation, it's Perez, Flanagan, and Donnelly. And a handoff is to Donnelly. Nice block on
room.
The outside by number 9.
Yep.
And Steven is fast.
Got some room.
Nice edge block right there by number 9, yep. Dana Isbell. Broke him free.
Move the
Regazzini
chains.
Regazzini out there too. Good blocking, guys.
Move
offensive line
chains.
On the right side. And it's a first down at the 40. Hold your blocks. And I'm screaming. Got me live. Okay, back in the same formation with a wing left. Regazzini is split out to the left. See if they're gonna, it's a quarterback keep.
Get a block.
Oh, he's got the block.
Get a block.
A great block right there.
Beautiful.
From behind. But a nice little chip block by Donnelly. And he picked up about 3 yards. Oof. Back at the line of scrimmage. And a little good blocking up front here. And, you know, we got some running backs that can run with the football. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah, you give them room.
And you give the quarterback time to throw, and he can do that too.
Timeout ready?
Timeout. Okay, here we go. Rockets with the ball, second down and eight at the 42-yard line. High formation, they got a wing right, and the handoff is to number seven. Good blocking out there.
Yep.
Oh, and the safety came in, but not before a pickup of about 4 or 5 hard yards. Good blocking up front by the Reading Rocket offense on the right side, doing the job. Maybe they've found a little crack over there on the right side.
Very, very big third down situation here. I mean, you're going to go for it on fourth anyways,
oh, yeah.
I would imagine.
Absolutely, you have to. It's the fourth quarter.
Fourth
we're halfway
quarter,
through.
Minutes.
Yep.
But, boy, it'd be sweet just to get the first down right now and not have to worry about a fourth down situation.
Okay. Well, the sun is out. We need some points here if we're going to win this ball game. Mm-hmm. Shotgun formation. We'll power right football. No, they're going left.
Get up the
little
field.
Little counter direction.
Okay.
Close. He's going to be about a yard. Yeah. Not even a yard shy. Well, let's see. Fourth down. Huge call coming up here.
I got fourth and 4 feet.
All right. You can see better than me. On the 49-yard line, in comes the play from Coach Robinson, big number 12, Nick Perez.
Fourth and one.
Fourth and one. And we need some blocking up front here. See what we're going to do. I think our quarterback keeper going to be a timeout by the Rockets. Okay, back live here, Reading Rockets, huge fourth down.
Fourth and one.
In the eye with the wing right. Donnelly's a halfback. Flanagan with a nice
there
block, and they picked it up. Good
beautiful
job
blocking.
Up front on the right side.
Beautiful blocking. That's enough to move.
Man.
That's what we want.
Good hard run. Great block by number seven, Flanagan, and a great job by the whole right side.
Ryan Sagala says first
left
down.
Right end. Ben Regazzini, and then number 73, Colin Webb, with great block. And I think the guard over there on the right-hand side is Sagala on
yes,
that particular play.
I believe it was number 51.
And I'm still trying to identify the guy with the lime green cleats under center. I think it's, Owen?
Don't know. I'll find out in a minute.
Here we go. First down, huge play. Outstanding job by the Rockets. Here's the handoff. And manhandled, oof, a little tough popping at the end of that.
Yeah.
But, you know, number nine at Dana Isbell's not going to take it, but that kid's, look at, that's that big fullback there, 55 for the Wildcats. Holy crow. Back live. Looks like a passing formation, but they want to spread it maybe to run a little more. Give Donnelly some open space. And it's Flanagan with the football, number seven. Hold your block, baby, get your block. There you go.
There's some.
Nice cut.
Good.
Huge, huge play.
Good.
Rockets with 5 minutes, according to the field clock.
We're driving.
Moving the chains here with great blocking again on the whole right-hand side. Good hard run on that play. The Rockets are looking like they might be in business here. Spread the field. Some bigger holes. Give the linemen a break. Outstanding job. Okay, here we go. Back to the line of scrimmage. Two guys stacked on the left-hand side. Got a wing right, and Donnelly is alone in the backfield with Nick Perez. Here comes number seven again. Fake the handoff.
He's got to get a block, get out there.
Yep. Wow. His own speed made that play.
That's it.
Great job good by deal. Nick.
Okay.
They faked the same play back to Kyle Flanagan, and he held the ball and made it all with those wheels of his. Good job by the Rockets.
Timeout.
Timeout Wildcats. We are back live here. A little power football. Looks like the old-fashioned T. It's a pitch to Flanagan. Got a block. No, stuffed. Got to find a man to block out there. Everybody's blocking. Pickup of about two.
Two on the
Not
play.
Bad.
Too bad.
And with 4:10, according to the field clock, to go, the Rockets are down at the 21-yard line of the Wildcats. Making some headway here, but clock is not our friend.
No. Although it has been a tale of two halves for the most part,
it
I'll
sure
tell you.
It sure has.
This Reading Rocket offense is now, looks like firing on all four cylinders here,
yep.
Or all eight cylinders.
Perez is alone, stacked to the right. He's going to keep it. He
yep,
needs a block.
Got a seam.
Oh, man. Interesting. Boy, the guys from Wilmington stayed home.
Yeah.
Coach was hoping they'd all follow him over to the right-hand side, but to no avail. And it's, again, about, well, I think he picked up about a yard. So with third down at the 24-yard line, 25-yard line, here come the Rockets once again. They've got a man split out wide to the right, and I believe that's Andrew Benassi, number 21. The handoff is to Flanagan, and the ball's on the ground.
Ah, oh, boy.
Oh, and he lost
that
it.
That looks like Wilmington's ball. Yeah.
Tough, tough
that is
break.
A tough one. That's a real tough break right there.
Came in and stripped the quarterback of the football.
Jeez.
Rough break. But okay, see if the defense can pull something out of the hat here. Wildcats with a big defensive play. Okay, so after a tough break, the Wildcats start on downs. First down from the Rocket 30, or their own 30, I should say. And it's just up the belly here, and it's time to seemingly kill the clock.
Yeah, I think he's, oh, he does. I don't know what he's got for timeouts. He may not.
Well, Chuck had to use two
yeah,
early.
Yeah, he used two earlier. He may have one left. One more in the kitty.
Good effort here today by the Rockets.
Definitely good effort.
You know, they started to move the ball. The defense played outstanding football against a very solid Wildcat team. So we'll see with a minute and a half to go. I doubt they're going to do anything fancy here. Quarterback is under center. Maybe we can give him a little forearm shiver.
That's it. They're just moving that ball up the gut there.
Okay, second down, and they are. They're killing the clock
yeah,
here.
Yeah, that's it. That's all they're going to do. They're going to run that clock right out, and that's a
tough break. The Rockets were moving the ball nicely. The guys up front started really getting some push and giving these fine running backs the Rockets have some space to move. Tough break.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Coach will have them working hard this week and get ready for next week's game. And
yeah, they played well. I mean, they played well. Just came up a little short.
Yep.
Looks like.
Okay. Love to see a fumble here. I don't think it's going to happen. Oh, my God. He's pushing the ball again. I don't get it. He almost broke out of there. But you're playing with fire. And
looks
that's
like,
going to
yeah,
do
that's
it.
That's going to be about it.
Okay,
yeah.
So tough loss for the Rockets here at home to open the season. 6-0 to an outstanding Wildcat team. I liked a lot of what I saw, though, today, Brian. What do you think?
Yeah, no, it's you know, the first game is always a tough one. And this Wilmington team is good. This is the team they played last year against, you know, in the playoffs.
In the playoffs, that's right.
But, you know, every week you get better, every week you improve, and I think this B team will be just fine.
I do, too. All right, thanks. Have a great week, guys.
Yep.